Next time you go into prayer and you feel that Trojan horse knocking on the door of your prayer, says you're really tired today. You shouldn't be praying. You say, listen, horsey, it's a wrong stall. You got a wrong house. You got to get out of that in Jesus' mighty name. Can somebody say amen? Next time you're in a computer and something creeps over your shoulder that tells you that you need to go on that website, you look it back and you say, devil, go to hell. That's exactly where you have to send him. That's what I teach people. When a bad thought comes to my mind, sometimes I will even say it in the shower. I will say it in front of other people really quietly. When something comes in my mind, and sometimes it's weird, you're simply doing something godly, or you're doing just something, minding your business, and just boom, it comes into your head. Like, where is that from? And I've developed my mind that when that happens, I know this is might not be scriptural, but I, under my breath, this is what I say. Go to hell, Satan, in Jesus' name. Now it's scriptural because that's where he's going to go. I do not want that thought to be in me. And one more thing before we pray. Remember this, a thought and a feeling cannot be fought with a thought and a feeling. It can only be fought with words. What that means is this, when you have a negative thought, it will not go away when you try to think a positive thought to overcome the negative thought. It will only go away when you speak a positive word against a thought. Only then the thought will subside. If you in your mind, people will look at you and say, what's going on with you? You're like, well, two thoughts are fighting. And then afterwards you're like, you know what? They both were fighting and I'm the one who's lost. I'm the one who's discouraged. I'm the one who's depressed. They were fighting and I'm the one who's weary. You know why? Because when Satan came to Jesus, most theologians agree, it wasn't a real Satan. It was in the form of a thought. How did Jesus fight him back? Not back with a thought, back with the word. You have to speak. When you feel down and you say, I don't want to pray, you have to say, I am strong. God is on my side and I want to pray. When you feel lustful and horny and the spirit of horniness comes on you, you have to say, I am holy, I am pure, and I do not want to sin. When you feel an urge to drink, you say, I love water, I love juice, and I love coffee. When you feel an urge to go and smoke, and you feel just an urge, you simply say, I love my health, do not want to kill my lungs and my kidneys and my body. I do not gonna do that. In Jesus' name. When you say it, you feel relief. When you think it, you're gonna have a headache. Can somebody say amen? I'm not telling you something that I don't live, and I'm not telling you something you cannot apply tomorrow. I'm telling you something you can put into practice, tonight, and put into practice tomorrow. Satan comes as a Trojan horse in the form of a thought, in the form of an emotion. The way these are stopped is when I get filled with Holy Spirit, and in the moment of my temptation, I speak. You may say, but what if other people think I'm crazy? It's fine. Satan won't think you crazy. He will think you're victorious. He will know that. Can somebody say amen?